you let them do this to you? I know it's nothing. With you, it's always nothing. Everything is a joke with you. School's a joke. Life's a joke. Giuseppe, you're 20 years old. You're a man, and that's a serious matter. In the name of God, what's going to happen to you? Giuseppe, you're a cross I can't bear anymore. I want to talk to your father.
Oh, no.
I know he's working. Well, let's go to his place of business. Dead. Two men in the house and I have to do everything.
My fault. I should have fixed that door. But I had more important things to do. You show her this. She'll feel better. I have to see a man about the job.
Good. And then you can unload Nino. And after that, you can clean up the mess in the house. What's that?
Diploma.
Diploma. Graduating in April. You, the donkey of the class. Whose idea was this? Ah, I see. Where is he? I have a special diploma for him. I graduate him right through the roof. Giuseppe, Giuseppe, you think I kept you in school all these years for this piece of paper? You think it didn't break my heart to see you a grown man among schoolboys? But at least I knew where you were. A place to go every day where the sisters could look after you. Now, what will I do with you? What will you do with yourself?
I can work as a carpenter, like Papa.
Carpenter? He hasn't driven a nail in 3 months. If you could be a carpenter or a shoemaker or a blacksmith, I'd be the happiest mother in the world. But you can't, Giuseppe. You can't, you understand? There you are, my son. Like Nino, you'll tug and strain to the end of your days. Expect the worst, then you won't be disappointed. Now go, unload Nino.
Nino. Nino. Look. Diploma. No more school. We are going to work. La 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 la.
Ha! Ha! Dame mezzo mare, Michele ma, Michele ma. E natta mezzo mare, Michele ma, Michele ma. Poi natta lo.
La 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 la. La 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 la.
Ah! 50 pennies a day and you are singing. Huh? 50 pennies a day and you are singing. Look.
Look.
You've had too much sun on your head.
Oh.
Idiot! Stupid imbecile! Look what you've done! My vines! I'll kill you!
Giuseppe.
Huh?
The bailiff has come at last. He's taken the house to clear my debts.
Baron Marco.
The Baron, here, at our house, you're crazy.
I ruined his vineyards.
Giuseppe! Giuseppe! Are you there, my son?
I just remember something. I have to see a man about the job.
Giuseppe,
we've been waiting for you. What have you done?
Oh, not again, not now.
Is Baron Marco here?
Baron Marco, he never had such a carrozza.
Don't recognize me, do you? How could you? The last time I saw you, I held you in my arms and baptized you.
Uncle Giovanni. Father Guardian Giovanni. He's just being appointed Father Guardian of the monastery at Martina.
This is Father Raspi, my nephew, Giuseppe.
He hurt himself in the service of God. Sit down, sit down. The wine, pour it. Cut some more cheese. Cut some more cheese. Come on. Eat, drink. This is your house.
That's enough, thank you.
Please, 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 Father Raspi. He's so nervous. Can you blame him? Never have we had such distinguished guests under this humble roof. My own brother, a prince of the church. Thank you, Almighty God, for answering a poor woman's prayer.
Francesca, please. I am only a doctor of the order. We have just come from Rome, where even bishops are as common as cats.
Don't be so modest. You are just like Giuseppe. Hardworking, reliable, intelligent. Ask Sister Nunziata, she will tell you. My son was the brightest student in the liceo, graduating 3 months ahead of the others. Would you like to see his diploma?
No, Francesca. I believe you.
I am not sure that this young man would fit into monastic life.
How can you say that? Talk to him. Give him a chance.
Perhaps my sister is right. This is a serious matter. We must not be too hasty. Giuseppe?
Giuseppe? Giuseppe, come here. Giuseppe, come here.
Sit down, my son. Sit down. Have you ever considered holy orders?
Priest.
We had something else in mind, Francesca. Something like a lay brother. We can always use a good carpenter, a mason, gardeners, laborers, whatever we must do in the service of Christ. I am sure there is a place for you at Martina. Agreed?
Let the young man decide for himself.
Idiot! Idiot! What do you want? To be under my feet all day, stuffing your belly, never bringing a cent into the house? Is that what you want? Losing one job after another like your worthless father? No wonder they call you Bocca Aperta, because you are a brainless idiot. This holy man of God offer you the chance of a lifetime and you don't want it. Why? Why, in God's name?
Mama, you know, I can't do any of those things. I'm not a carpenter, I'm not a mason.
But at least try.
I've tried 100 times, I can't do it. I know it.
Signora, perhaps Giuseppe knows his limitations. Monastic life is hard, very hard. The discipline is severe.
But, Father,
I... There you are, Francesca. It was Giuseppe's decision to make, and he has made it.
Mama. Mama.
Giuseppe, my son.
What is it, Mama?
These attacks. I didn't want to worry you with them, but I'm not long for this world, my son. Oh, Giuseppe. Giuseppe, what's to become of you after I'm gone? Who's to take care of you?
Mama, don't worry. I'll find a way.
Promise me, son.
I can't be saying anything.
Go to the monastery with your uncle. Live the life of a holy man. What more can a mother ask of her boy? To know that God watches over him, protecting him from the wickedness of the world. Oh. Promise, Giuseppe.
I promise. Anything. Anything, Mama.
Francesca. Perhaps you had better rest a while.
Rest? We are going to eat, drink, celebrate. This is the happiest day of my life. Come on, get some more.
Your sister is a remarkable woman, Father. If she were a man, she'd be a bishop.
She'd be the Pope.